When the United States entered World War II, determined to destroy the war machines of Germany and Italy, the initial burden fell upon the Army Air Corps. The battle-tested RAF gave its wholehearted cooperation, but there was no let-up to the British argument against daytime raids. They had seen Hitler's Luftwaffe employ such tactics over Britain in 1940 and fail. And their own daylight raids on Germany had resulted in heavy losses. Then Churchill agreed to try the United States strategy, and the Allies began their round-the-clock bombing, pounding the Rhineland and selected targets in occupied France night and day. To avoid congestion of the narrow airspace above the British Isles, an ingenious timetable was worked out by the Allies. Thereafter, without let-up, the two cooperating air forces roared over ball-bearing factories of Regensburg and Schweinfurt and the oil refineries of Hamburg and Ploesti. The huge industrial targets were primary, but the ultimate purpose of the concentration would be to weaken the Luftwaffe and soften up the German and Italian defenses for the ultimate land invasion. During what was called the Big Week in February 1944, the RAF sent 2,300 night bombers over Germany, and during that same period, 3,800 American Air Force planes roared through the enemy skies. Then we hit the beaches and assaulted the fortress of Europe. The landings on the French coast and the race to Paris and ultimately to Berlin are the best documented military operations in history. But our story really begins with the landings at Palermo, Sicily, and Taranto in Italy. This was to be the soft underbelly of Europe, a quick and efficient minor operation of the grand plan. But the soft underbelly had a spine of fortified mountains. It was plated with steel, and it trembled with the bombs of the Luftwaffe. From Salerno to Anzio to Cassino, GIs who thought they would take a little walk in the Italian sun were provided with some of the hardest fighting of the war. The winter of 1943 and 44 was unusually severe. Muddy roads and plains, freezing cold, mountains choked with snow, became allies to the soldiers of the Third Reich. The Americans had hit a winter stalemate. Day after day, the GIs answered the artillery of the Germans, who poured their fire down on the attackers from well-fortified positions in the mountains. It suddenly became a strange and old-fashioned kind of war. A very personal kind of war. It was a bloody, nerve-wracking fight against ingenious devices of an ingenious enemy. To break the stalemate created by thousands of landmines, a new kind of soldier appeared in the field. Part engineer, part daredevil, part psychologist. He was the demolition expert. The demo squad didn't concern itself with artillery or aircraft. Each member could find his own private hell with a wrong step or a nervous hand. There was no strike two for the Hell Raiders.
Yeah. Tex, plant one here.
Major, if I can make a suggestion, that bend in the road up there would make a good trap for trucks. It's harder for a lookout to spot a mine from a truck.
Plant it here.
Yes, sir. That's a support of 3rd Engineers. It's not a latrine, it's a landmine machine.
Any chance of taking 10, sir? This retreating business ain't exactly easy on my back.
You heard the man. Dig.
If those Nazis weren't so hot on our trail, I'd collapse right here and not get up.
Well, the body can only stand so much, Captain.
You just remember that the next time the MPs haul you out of Mama Rose's in Foggia. Dig.
I think he's trying to tell me something.
That old broad catch you chasing that kid of her through the woods. She's gonna cut off more of your credit.
Hey, listen, I'm crazy about Gina. Besides, she ain't caught us yet.
Yeah, it's not all you're gonna catch either.
You lay off that kind of talk, Tex. She's my girl.
And his best friends won't even tell him.
Knock it off, you two. You're surrounded by krauts and you think it's a picnic. We'll be lucky to get out of this operation as POWs. Now move.
My feet are killing me, sir.
I don't like it out here in the open, Major.
Okay, we'll take 10, over in the woods.
What's the matter, kid? Look, it's always tough meeting the enemy for the first time. But you'll pull that first trigger, and you're off.
Man, it's just that simple. Then nothing matters, nothing. I'll never forget my first scrap. After it was all over, I was the only one making any noise. Someone told me later that I screamed all the way through it. Nothing seemed real.
Really, Tex?
Hell yes. Then I went ape, booze, lost my master sergeant stripes. You see before you a perennial buck-ass private.
I get sick every time I think of killing someone.
You won't believe this, son, but I had a colonel in the First World War. He used to heave like crazy every time a barrage started. He's the best damn heaver I ever seen. But one thing about it, he never was constipated. I never could figure that out. What's all that?
Oh, writing to Dad. You know, Tex, you kind of remind me of him.
Yeah?
Well, kind of.
That's a good idea, son, writing you folks. They always like to hear from their kids.
You ever had any kids, Tex?
Well, none that I know of. Thank you.
Spread out. Take cover.
About that, they're using our equipment.
Halt.
What's that?
The kid was writing a letter.
Dear Dad, here I am in Italy. The name of this valley is Varno. It's 20 miles long and 6 miles wide. And it should bring about 50 cents a square mile on a good market. This dump was supposed to be a secondary supply depot and administration center. We just moved into the new buildings when the Krauts swamped us. They outnumbered us 20 to 1. We didn't have a chance to destroy anything, records, equipment, nothing. Dad, I saw men die today for the first time. Maybe one of my bullets killed someone. I guess this boy didn't know much about censorship.
Yeah, I guess he was too young to know much about anything except dying, sir.
Yeah, I know. Major, we're gonna have to get back in there and destroy that administration building where the records are kept. Headquarters insists.
Well, I've already tried two frontal attacks, sir. It'd be suicide to try with what I have left.
Major, that's exactly what the colonel told headquarters. They merely said to take it.
Well, not by force, we won't.
What do you mean, not by force? You got a better suggestion?
Maybe.
Like what?
Give me a handful of top demolition men, sir. I think we'd have a better chance than a whole company of infantry.
You actually think you can infiltrate the enemy positions? I don't know.
I think I can pull it off, sir.
How about volunteers? Now, you know I can't just order men out on a suicide mission just like that.
With certain inducements, I can get them in, sir.
Inducements? What kind of inducements?
A 72-hour pass in Foggia and 3 months' pay in their pockets.
That's a bit irregular, Major.
But not unreasonable under the circumstances, sir.
Can you get me a detailed plan within the hour?
Yes, sir. Colonel, it would help if you'd have Captain Stevens do the recruiting.
I'll talk to him.
Thank you, sir.
Got two messages, Colonel. One from Captain Blake. He's withdrawn to defensive positions as ordered.
Anything about casualties?
Yes, sir. They're very heavy. And here's one from Foggia.
And what's that den of iniquity got to say?
Alora Grant of National Press Service requests permission to cover action up here.
Permission refused. Wait a minute. I do have a message for her. You just tell her to get the hell out of this area.
Yes, sir.
First ones and the last ones out. The 43rd Engineers. If there's a drink to be had, we'll find it, no doubt. The 43rd Engineers. We'll push up a building or tire down a hill.
The crops don't get you the rations well. The 43rd Engineers.
You know, a guy can get scared with all that shooting.
He can also get killed, son.
Jean would never forgive me if I got killed. She'd think it was an excuse to get out of marrying her.
Are you gonna get married?
Sometimes there's no other way. I ain't got time to find out.
One of those things could have my name on it. It'll be painless, Tex. You can't read. Hey, Tex. How many wars you lived through?
Five, counting three marriages.
Wow, and you're still alive.
Yep.
As you were, the answer's still hungry.
Just had a talk with the colonel.
Lottie bleeding down. Something's coming up, and it ain't joy.
He's looking for the best demolition men we've got.
So naturally, you thought of us. Right, sir?
It's a volunteer mission.
My dogs is killing me.
Why don't you write a song about it?
I'm reading a book. I gotta find out who killed the butler. Sir?
There are some compensations. A 72-hour pass in Foggia and 3 months' pay to blow in Sin City. 72 hours and 3 months' pay to blow it in with. Terrible, sinful town, Foggia.
What's the catch, Cap?
It's a rough job. Odds 1,000 to 1.
What do you think we got now?
Well, that's what I've been trying to say. We're outmanned, outgunned,
and outhoused. I remember once in North Africa. Or was it?
Eddie's. I got the money right here. It's all yours, no strings.
Captain, you've just convinced me to be patriotic.
You might even get to see your girl, Campisi.
You're right, sir. To deny her would be unmanly of me. Come on, Frankie. We'll break in.
What do you mean? What do you mean? I've been there.
I bet.
Well, I have. I'll prove it.
Can we watch?
We head for Foggia right away. I'll check in with the colonel.
Mama Rosa's, here we come.
Huh? Okay, I'm with you.
It's all a one-way street anyway.
Thanks.
I wouldn't want you men to get the idea that you'd been conned into this little operation, okay?
Friends, we just had a snow job.
The building will be heavily patrolled.
I know that, sir. That's why we're going to split up into three teams of two men. The element of surprise, one team might get through.
How about supplies, explosives?
I've already taken care of that, sir.
Colonel? I've got the men. They're getting ready to go on pass.
Major Paxton will brief you, Captain.
I thought I was to be in command, sir.
I didn't say that.
Major Paxton wasn't mentioned when you asked me to recruit the men, sir.
Major Paxton was busy working out the details of this mission, Captain. Does that seem to bother you?
It's all right with me, sir, if the captain wants out.
Gentlemen, we're not playing tiddlywinks here. This is a very serious mission which may involve the lives of many men. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Maybe you'd be better off without him at that.
Captain Stevens is the best explosives officer we have, sir. He'll do his job. Well, sir?
Enjoy your pass on Foggia, Major.
The men will. Thank you, Colonel.
Good luck. Good luck, Major. Strange man, Major Paxton. Very hard to understand.
You never know what's in a man's past, sir.
I guess not.
Are holding.
Stick with it. Stick with it.
One deck, baby. I'm going to the adjutant's office.
See you later.
72 hours later, I hope.
Go!
Mamma mia! Mamma mia!
Good old Paisano, baby.
Come on, Tex, let's go.
Signor. Oh, bambino.
Bye-bye.
Buongiorno, Capitano.
Foggia calling Big Fish. Foggia calling Big Fish. Over.
Major Paxton, I wasn't expecting you until later.
My men were in kind of a hurry.
Welcome to our little ghost town.
Yeah, it seems pretty well deserted. When are you leaving?
In a couple of days. I stayed behind to try to organize some of the Italians.
Any luck?
Oh, some.
I thought only military personnel and townspeople were left in Foggia.
Would you mind waiting in the room across the hall?
Yes, sir.
Frankly, Major, I forgot about her. Correspondent, Laura Grant. She landed this morning. Before we could get her away, the airstrip was bombed and the plane completely destroyed.
Well, get her out of here, now.
I have no transportation.
When'd you say you were leaving?
Day after tomorrow.
But if you can't get her out sooner, you'll have to take her with you.
Yes, sir.
Colonel? We've lost contact with Captain Blake.
Well, that opens the Foggia road. Tell Beckman to move in.
No answer there either, sir.
Get Burton in Foggia. Tell him to alert Paxton of a breakthrough. Tell him to get moving with his demolition squad.
Good evening. How do you do? A good evening. How the no. A good evening. How do you do? Good evening. How do you do? A bon, bon. No beer, champagne. No beer, champagne. In case of trouble, bull you, baby. Bull you, baby. Bull you, baby.
Mama, I needed some money.
Don't bother me, in the drawer.
All right, all right.
Bull you, baby.
Gina, you go home.
No.
I said you go home, Gina. Never mind why, go home.
What's it all? Where did Gina go?
Gina, soldier boy, out of sight.
Outside?
Okay, well, let's go.
Sarah, gentlemen. Come in there.
Hey, look at that.
Oui. Sarah.
Hello, Ron.
Aura?
Aren't you going to ask me to sit down?
You know, you have no business here.
Why do you think I came?
You asking me or telling me?
I was hoping I'd find you.
Okay. You found me.
Don't blame me for what happened in London, Ron.
I'm not blaming you. Just leave me alone.
Well, then stop blaming yourself for something that would have happened anyway. We loved each other, Ron.
I'll see that you're evacuated just as soon as I can make the arrangements. Stevens, Chow.
Chow.
You know, you're wasting your time and your assets on the major.
His blood is ice water. His emotions have been cataloged and stored in deep freeze. He's a fighting man. He's a fighting man's fighting man. He has no time out for weaknesses or women or anything. And I hate his guts.
You're well on your way, aren't you?
Oh, if you mean am I drunk? No, I've only had 12. Have a drink.
What's he done to you?
Probably a lot less than he's done to you. Oh, nothing but be superior besides being my superior officer.
I think you envy him.
You're too sober for me. Come on, get down to my level.
I don't think I should. Oh, they're getting closer, aren't they? Are you trying to get me drunk, Captain Stevens?
Yep.
You're very literate and a little crazy. Why not?
Now you're beginning to understand me.
Oh, I'm beginning to get high.
What we need is some fresh air. Come on. Oh, now don't start playing coy again. You know there may be no tomorrow.
Oh.
Corny, huh?
No.
Come on, let's go anyway. Come on.
And within the hour, the BBC has confirmed the bad news about Operation Husky. Mr. Churchill had envisioned a series of landings at Latino and Anzio to surprise the Germans and encircle the Gustav Line. This would have been followed by a dash to the Alban Hills and a thrust towards Rome. However, Allied forces paused to consolidate the beachheads before pushing inland. During this 10-day lull, the Luftwaffe and Nazi reserve units have been rushed in from inactive sectors of the Gustav Line, and the Anzio forces are pinned down. Every foot of the beachheads and harbors are extremely vulnerable. German artillery in the hills and enemy dive bombers. This is Gerald McEwen, BBC.
I love you, Laura.
I wonder what Freud would have to say about that. Frightened, Brad. Terribly frightened.
Of the guns?
No, it's really not the guns, but they are frightening.
Well, that's one of the purposes of them, psychologically speaking. But they do destroy and maim and can be quite precise in death dealing.
Yet all of you go out of your way looking for... for death. Why?
We don't look for it, baby. At least I don't. But someone has to do it, that's all. You'd have to be nuts to look for death.
The Major, how does he feel?
Oh, yes, the Major. Well, grudgingly, I have to admit that he's fearless. He's done some pretty crazy things. This little caper we've got coming up is just this side of sanity.
I was afraid of that.
You know him pretty well, don't you?
Pretty well.
When we were stationed in London, I remember reading where he got a lot of publicity during one of the Blitz air raids. He saved a lot of people's lives during an air raid. Did you know him then?
Yes. His wife and son were killed in the same air raid in another part of town. I was with him when it happened.
Well, that's honest anyway. To hell with everything. Come here.
Please, Brad. Let's go.
You call the shot.
Major, I've arranged the escape rendezvous with some Italians. They'll pick you up on the coast road and put you aboard a boat.
Can we depend on them?
Well, anything could happen with civilians.
Yeah, that's what I'm afraid of, so I won't count on it. Well, I guess I'll go back to the hotel. Oh, have you done anything about that photographer, Laura Grant?
I'm afraid she'll have to wait until I leave.
excuse me?
Am I being outranked?
I did come out here to cover a story.
I'll buy part of that. Time.
Does it matter?
What do you want, Laura?
Either get me out of this town or let me cover the front lines.
You'll be leaving with Captain Burton. That's the best I can do. And you can't go into the battle zone.
I can see why your men love you like they do. It must be your sweet nature. Do you have to take your bitterness out on everyone? How do you think I felt when you disappeared from London without even knowing what happened to you? All I knew was that you went on a roaring drunk and then transferred. You didn't even come back to your apartment for your clothes. How do you think I felt, Ron? Oh, God, I loved you.
Stay off my back, Laura. I've got enough to think about.
Please, please, Ron, don't cut me out like this.
Look, I've got a job to do, a very unpleasant job. I've got to take five men on a mission that could cost them their lives.
I'm sorry. Maybe I'm selfish. Maybe you think that I don't understand or feel for you. But I do, Ron, I do feel...
Position Sparrow. This is Foggia. Over.
Displaying incredible raw courage, the American Fifth Army under General Mark Clark and the British 56th Infantry Division commanded by General Templar have formed a liaison that has broken out from the beachheads, driving a wedge through the encircling Germans. The hard push to Rome has begun. Says the enemy is falling back on Naples and Cassino. However, there is heavy fighting and the enemy is blowing up bridges and railways and other arteries in a desperate attempt to slow the Allied advance. The War Office spokesman says that much of the shelling and destruction of non-military targets by the Germans is by way of revenge for Italian defection. Although the spine of the Luftwaffe has been broken in Italy, remaining enemy units are making the Allies pay dearly for their successes on Italian soil. An Allied communique from the Italian front reports that the Germans are now in full retreat up the Rapido Valleys. But the success of the Turanian coast and mainland confrontations has been bought at a price consisting of minor operations in Bari, Tamoli, and Foggia. The bypassing of these towns on the Adriatic Sea has left many Allied units virtually surrounded by remnants of strong Nazi forces. Thus it is in any grandiose military plan, a major victory is accompanied by sacrifices behind the lines from materials. Not until Rome is occupied and the last Nazi removed from Italian soil can we assess the extent of these sacrifices.
Campisi.
Okay. Now we're gonna need some high-level strategy.
Did I ever let you down?
No.
In the truck.
Great.
And this, sir, is from the north sector.
You're in and out of the hotel, sir. Nobody's there. Even Lucio's cleared out.
Well, I'll try Mama Rosa. She'll know where they are. We're moving out as soon as I can round them up.
Good luck, Major.
We'll need it.
Guten Abend, wie geht's? Guten Abend, wie geht's? Kein Bier, nur Champagne. Kein Bier, nur Champagne.
Go away, Yankee. German comes through.
Where are my men?
I know. They're at Gina's house.
German, Cappy, stop!
Where's Gina live?
I show you. Come. Hide.
Oh, no, no hide here! No hide here!
Willkommen, Herr Major.
Where is the Americana?
Oh, go.
Where's your personal situation map?
Burton. John. Captain. 0314304.
Where is your personal situation map?
Burton. John. Captain. 0314304.
Well, we made it, baby. What do you think about that?
Seattle?
Yeah, you said it. We settled in Seattle.
Soldier, get in the vehicle.
Oh, come on, sir. This
you
is
heard
fiance.
Me, Cambisi. Move!
Well, I haven't even...
Get in the vehicle. We're leaving. Laura.
What the hell are you doing here?
What difference does it make?
Laura. The Germans have taken over Foggia. I've got to take these men on a mission.
Take me with you.
I can't.
Ron?
In three teams of two men each. Tex, you with me. Captain, you take Frankie. That leaves Al and Buddy for the third team. Now, this is our mission. In our former headquarters, we left some intelligence records. The names of just about all the partisan fighters in this area. The manner in which they receive their supplies and the delivery points. You know what happens if the Germans get it. We weren't able to destroy those records, and as far as we know, they're still there.
And they might have been found, sir.
Maybe, but we don't think so. In any case, we have to know for sure. Now, about 20 feet from the bottom of the basement stairs, there's some loose boards. Underneath is a natural cache. Everything in there must be completely destroyed. Any questions?
No, sir.
Okay, we leave at 0200. We should be there by 0345. At 0350, each team strikes. Remember, I want complete destruction. We'll take 6 one-hour watches.
I'll take the first one, Major.
I'll take over, Tex.
Thank you, sir. Major, it's real pleasant. It's hard to believe a couple of miles.
Go on, get some rest.
Major, we've given you a pretty rough time of it, haven't we?
No more than usual. I understand you were once a master sergeant. Is that right?
Yes, sir. But I got what was coming to me. Had a lot of fun. Major, I've been a soldier in the biggest part of my life. Served under some mighty fine men. But you're right up here with the best.
Thank you.
Being a non-com is all right, but basically, I'm just an F.O.
When did it all stop, Tex?
What?
The F.O.ing? I heard that you lost your whole family in an epidemic down in Texas.
Yes, sir. But I've really forgotten that. I figured there's a reason to it, like why we're here fighting this war. You know what I mean, sir? I think you should try to forget, too.
Tex, if we get out of this, I'd like to see you get your stripes back.
When we get out of it, sir?
When we get out of it. Now go on and get some rest.
They wasn't a soldier and major. They was just out for a moonlight walk.
Well, that's good. They don't suspect anything.
This stuff's getting away a ton.
Well, it's gonna get heavier.
Sign of the other. Well, they must be all right, otherwise we'd have hurt something.
Mm-hmm.
Gene, all right?
It's all right. It's all right.
Now, look. I'm gonna go get some help. I'll be back as soon as I can, all right? Okay? I'll be back as soon as I can.
Wait for you.
What are you doing here?
A patrol jumped us. Buddy's hit. I came to get some help.
Get back on your job.
What are you gonna let him lay there and bleed to death?
I can't do anything about it now. We've got a job to do.
Well, I'm going back.
You're staying here.
Yeah?
It's time to move out.
Let's go. Well, I'm going back.
The major said forget it.
Now is the time, Lazarus.
Thank you.
Kaminsky!
Must be in trouble. Get over there and help him, Al. All right, let's move out.
What are you waiting for, Smitty?
Like I was gonna make it for a while, sir.
Sorry, Tex.
Hey. Can you take care of that?
Don't worry about me. Get in there and set off that charge.
Knock it off. I'm in command now. Major, platitudes nauseate me, so I'm gonna give it a real switch. I hated your guts the first time I met you, and I haven't changed my mind. Outside of that, good luck. Yeah, I know. You'll need a ride. I don't know where the hell I was going anyway.